If you've recently signed up for YouTube TV, this is the ultimate beginner's guide to help you get started. Today, I'm going to walk you through the basics step by step in real time. You'll learn how to navigate YouTube TV's home screen, live guide, and library, which is where you access your DVR. Plus, I'll share some account settings and features to maximize your viewing experience. For this free training, you'll need a YouTube TV account. Sign up for your free trial of YouTube TV at tv.youtube.com. You'll also need other streaming basics, a TV set, an internet connection, and a supported streaming device. I'll be using a ROKU Ultra for this tutorial, but this training will still be useful if you're using another device to stream. And if you need help setting up a ROKU, watch my separate tutorials linked in the description. To get the most out of this experience, I recommend that you watch this video either from your phone or your computer, not your TV set, because that way you can follow along on your TV set the steps that I'm about to explain. Let's begin. Signing in to YouTube TV. There are several ways to access YouTube TV: a web browser, mobile app, and your TV set. From your TV set, which is what we're going to focus on in this video, search for the YouTube TV app if it's not already installed. And please note, the YouTube TV app is separate from the regular YouTube app. When you launch the YouTube TV app for the very first time, you should see a screen like this. If you've already signed up directly at tv.youtube.com, select Member Sign In and choose from one of the options on your screen. To sign in from a web browser, go to tv.youtube.com/start, enter the code on your screen, and then sign in to your Google account. To sign in with your phone, download and open the YouTube TV mobile app. And as long as your phone is connected to the same Wi-Fi as your TV set, you'll be able to select your Google account and sign in this way. When you sign into YouTube TV for the first time, you'll see multiple screens to help you personalize your experience. Select your favorite news shows, movies, TV series, and even sports teams to follow with your DVR. If you're following the steps as I'm speaking, you may need to pause the video right now so that you can finish the personalization process, and then we can continue. Let's pick up with what the YouTube TV home screen looks like on a TV set. From the navigation at the top, you can click left for your library and to the right for the live guide. I want to walk you through the home screen later on. First, click right and select Live, Live Guide. This is the YouTube TV live guide. At the top of your screen, you'll see a collection of programs that are airing right now. Click down once on your remote, then you can scroll to the right. Notice that as I scroll through the On Now section, the channel logos change to thumbnails of particular shows. There's also a live bug in the lower left corner. Below the thumbnail graphic for each show, you see the name of the show, the network that it's airing on, and the time that it airs. Now, pick a program from the On Now section and press OK. Your screen will turn black briefly for a second or two. That's normal. Then you'll be taken to the live program that you selected. For now, let's return to the live guide. I'll press back on my ROKU remote. Notice that when you're navigating the live guide, the last channel that you watched will play in the background. If you arrow up to the very top of the guide, you'll also see the name of that program. Let's make our way to the main live guide, which is below the On Now section. Arrow down until you reach the first channel. That's ABC News Live from my current view. You see there is a description of the highlighted show at the top of the screen. If you find something that you want to watch, just press OK and you'll be taken directly to it. Just like I showed you with the On Now selection, you can click back from Live TV to return to the live guide. And if you want to preview content that's coming up later on, scroll to the right of the guide. Watch as I select a program that's airing in the future. When I press OK, I can choose to add it to my library or browse episodes that may be available on demand. Next, I'll arrow to the left of the live guide and highlight a channel logo. When you press OK on a channel logo, you're taken to a page that shows you what's airing live and what's coming up on that network only. In addition, you can browse that network's on-demand library of shows and movies. Click back on your remote to return to the live guide. Above the network logos, you see a menu option with three horizontal lines. Click on this to reorder the live guide. There are a handful of ways to personalize the live guide. For example, you can display channels by most watched or in alphabetical order. You can also create a custom guide to see only the channels that you watch. But to create or edit your custom live guide, you need to log into YouTube TV from either a computer or the mobile app. So I'll show you how to do this later on in this tutorial. For now, I'm back on the live guide and have the networks in A to Z order. Notice that ABC News Live is first. Now I'm going to speed up the video to show you that I'm scrolling down all the way to the weather channel. I press OK to go directly to what's on right now. Then, as I showed you before, I click back to return to the live guide. When I clicked back only once on my Roku remote, it returned me to the section of the guide where I left off. You see, the weather channel is still highlighted. But if you ever want to return to the top of the guide, simply click back a second time, and that should do the trick. As you can see, ABC News Live is at the top again. Live TV options. Follow along as I select a program from the live guide and we'll continue our tutorial with live TV options. When you're watching a live program, you can pause, rewind, and fast forward using the keys on your remote. Click the down arrow once on your Roku remote to see information about the show as well as the timeline. Click down a second time to reveal additional options. I'll start on the left with the three dots. I rarely use this section, but you see audio options, auto pause, send feedback, and stats for nerds. The next section, which has a little box with HD on it, is for video quality, and I usually keep mine on auto. Next to that is closed captioning, and to the right of that is a plus symbol. When you click on that, you have the option to add a program to your library. As we continue with these options, you see networks. When this is highlighted, click down once again to scroll through the mini guide. This allows you to channel surf without going back to the main live guide. And to the right of networks, click on episodes to view upcoming programming. And finally, select more to watch, and you'll find a mix of live and on-demand programming that relates to the program you're currently watching. Right now, I'll click back on my remote to return to the live guide. Home screen navigation. The word live is highlighted at the top of the screen. From here, arrow to the left one time to access the home screen. And this is what will display when you first open YouTube TV. Top picks for you are highlighted at the top of the screen. These recommendations will improve over time as you use the service. Click down for the resume watching section. This will feature both live programs and on-demand content. You can keep scrolling down for various types of content. The Add to Membership section highlights add-ons. These are all optional. And Add to Your Library is the next section. We're going to talk about the library next, so let's click OK on one of these programs and go ahead and add it to the library. Here, you can choose to set mobile reminders, and you'll get notified when the show airs live. Click back to return to the home screen and scroll down for a selection of sports programs, including events airing live. The home screen is a good place to browse. There are various shows and movies featured as I continue pressing down on my Roku remote. And toward the very bottom of the screen, you'll find an alphabetized list of networks. Library, Cloud DVR. I'll press up on my Roku remote and hold it to quickly get to the top of the home screen again. And from the main navigation, watch as I click left to the library. This is your Cloud DVR. When you add a show to the library, as I demonstrated in the previous section, it will show up here. If you know that you want to record something but can't easily find it on the home screen or through the live guide, there is always the search function. Watch as I scroll to the right and press OK on the magnifying glass. I'll type in Friends as an example, and when I click through to the result, I can click on the plus symbol to add the show to my library. Then, All episodes of the series will be recorded. Unlimited cloud DVR storage is included, so no need to worry about running out of space. For sports recordings, there are more options. For example, I searched for the Boston Celtics and added the team to my library. That way, all upcoming games will be recorded. But you also have the flexibility to record only a single sporting event. You can also record by league. I searched NFL, and when I click Add to Library, I can choose recording options, including specific teams and network games. I'll click back several times to return to the library screen. Since I'm demonstrating from a new account, there's not a whole lot to see here, so I want to show you my library from another YouTube TV account. If you're following the steps with me, take a break and just watch this part. From my library on my other account, focus on the filters to the left of the screen. New in your library is shown by default. See something you're ready to watch? Just click the thumbnail and select an episode. This is important. Notice that this episode of House Hunters says choose a version. If this option is present, always select DVR and not VOD. With DVR, you can fast forward through the ads. VOD has unskippable ads. So if you want to be able to skip the ads, just remember to add programs to your library. It's that simple. Back on the library page, I scrolled down to Scheduled. This is where you can see programs that are being recorded right now or sometime in the not-too-distant future. Watch as I select a program that's being recorded right now. You will be given the option to join the program live or start from the beginning. But even if you join the program live, you can always rewind to an earlier portion in the recording. Just use the keys on your ROKU remote for that. I'm back on the library page. For some of the filters like shows, movies, and sports, YouTube TV helps you organize your DVR. In the upper right corner, there is a menu, and this allows you to reorder the content in your library. Filters include things like recently recorded, alphabetical, trending, and most popular. Let's talk now about account settings and features. You can follow along with me for this section. And next, I want to make my way to the right of the screen and select my account icon. From there, you can scroll down and click on Settings. This is a key point. Some of these options can be changed from a TV set, but others require that you sign in at tv.youtube.com. So for example, when I click on Membership, I'm directed to the website or the YouTube TV mobile app. But before I show you that, let's go over the things that you can do directly from a TV set. First, scroll down to Autoplay on Start. If you see this option, you can choose to have a top recommendation play automatically or not. Don't see this option? Just keep it moving. It's not that big of a deal. And now I'm on the filter setting. This is something you'd want to adjust if you have a child using your account. And under Privacy, manage your search and watch history. You can choose to pause or delete your data entirely from this setting. But keep in mind, doing so will affect your recommendations going forward. Several other settings are really important, but I need to log into YouTube TV from a computer to show you how they work. Before we do that, let me show you how to exit the YouTube TV app. If you have a ROKU device, you can just click Home on your remote to close YouTube TV and return to the ROKU home screen. Clicking back a few times on your remote also gives you an exit option. Or, from your account icon in the upper right corner, there is an exit option toward the bottom of the list. Be careful though, click Exit, not Sign Out. Let's dive into those other account settings. Sign in at tv.youtube.com and we'll continue. If this is your first time logging into YouTube TV from a web browser, you'll notice that it looks different from the TV set. And that's true about the YouTube TV mobile app as well. But if you ever want to stream YouTube TV on your phone or computer, the training we've gone through today will still be helpful. Just know that the look and feel is slightly different across various devices. Let's get back on track to the account settings. From the web browser, select your account icon in the upper right corner of the screen and tap Settings. Now, on the left side of the screen, you can see many of the options that I just showed you. The difference is that you can actually control everything from a web browser, while settings are limited from a TV set. Let's start with membership. Select your YouTube TV plan and click Manage. From here, you can choose to pause or cancel your membership. The billing section is where you can change payment methods, and family sharing is next. The primary account holder can invite other members of the same household to share a YouTube TV membership. And that way, members of the family get their own DVR and recommendations. Scroll down and select the live guide. This is where you can create the custom live guide that I talked about earlier in the training. Place check marks next to the networks that you want to see in your guide and drag them up or down to your preferred order. Then, from whatever device you're using, choose the custom guide filter from your live guide. Finally, I'll point out the area section. This is one you won't use much, but you can adjust the home and playback area if you move or travel. Contact YouTube TV. If you have trouble getting started with YouTube TV, I'm happy to answer your questions down below, but it's probably a better idea for you to contact YouTube TV directly. From a web browser, click the question mark and select Contact Us. Once you explain your issue, you'll get contact options like phone and live chat. If you're away from a computer, you can also contact support from YouTube TV's mobile app. If you found this training helpful, please give this video a like and check out my other videos with more advanced YouTube TV tips and tricks.